compute the second moment of area, that is moment of inertia of the channel section shown in figure 5 about the centroidal axis xx and yy. Here is the channel section with a length 100 and height 400 with a web thickness 8.1 in the middle and 13.5 mm at the top and at the bottom. The given channel section is symmetrical about x-axis, that is total distance is 400, y bar is 400 divided by 2, that is nothing but 200 equal to y bar. Now we consider this as element 1, then element 2, then element 3. Here is 100, then 13.5 100, and the mid portion is, this is calculated as 400 minus twice 13.5 is equal to 400 minus 27. 400 minus 27 is nothing but 373. This is 1 and this is 2 and this is termed as 3. Now we have A1 is equal to 100 multiplied by 13.5. 100 multiplied by 13.5. 100 multiplied by 13.5. Nothing but 1350 mm². X1 is equal to, we have the reference axis x, and x1 is equal to 100 divided by 2, that is equal to 50 mm. Then y1 is equal to, we have the element value, that is we have this element 1 and the base value, the total is, total value is 400 minus this value is 13.5. Therefore, 400 minus 13.5 divided by 2 implies 400 minus 13.5 is equal to y1. It's nothing but 386.5 mm. y1 is equal to, this total value is 400 minus 13.5. y1 is equal to 400 minus 13.5 divided by 2 is nothing but 393.25 mm. A2 is equal to this web thickness 8.1 multiplied by 373 is nothing but 8.1 multiplied by 373, 3021.3 mm². X2 is equal to total is 8.1, therefore X2 is equal to 8.1 divided by 2 is equal to 4.05 mm. Y2 is equal to, here is 13.5, let us say we have the second element, this is the second element, this is G2, X2, Y2, then we have the third element which is at a height of 13.5, therefore total y2 can be calculated as 13.5 plus 373 divided by 2. 373 divided by 2. Y2 is equal to 13.5 plus 373 divided by 2 implies y2 is equal to 13.5 plus 373 divided by 2 is equal to 200 mm. Y2 is equal to 200 mm. Similarly, a3 is equal to 100 into 13.5 is nothing but 1350 mm square. X3 is equal to 100 divided by 2. X3 is equal to 100 divided by 2. Is nothing but 50 mm. Y3 is equal to 13.5 divided by 2, which is equal to 13.5 divided by 2, which is equal to 6.75 mm. Now x bar is equal to a1 x1 plus a2 x2 plus a3 x3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. This implies x bar is equal to a1. a1 is 1350 multiplied by x1, it is 50, plus a2. a2 is 3021.3 into x2. x2 is 4.05 plus a3. a3 is 1350 into x3. x3 is 50 divided by 1350 plus 3021.3 plus 1350. This implies x bar is equal to 1350 multiplied by 50 plus 3021.3 multiplied by 4.05 plus 1350 multiplied by 50 is equal to answer divided by 1350 plus 3021.3 plus 1350 is equal to 25.734 mm. We already know y bar is equal to 200. We can check y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3 implies y bar is equal to a1 1350 multiplied by y1. y1 is 393.25 plus a2 is nothing but 3021.3 a2. y2 is 200 plus y3. a3 is 1350 into y3. y3 is 6.75 divided by 1350 plus 3021.3 plus 1350. This implies y bar is equal to 1350 multiplied by 393.25 plus 3021.3 multiplied by 200 plus 1350 multiplied by 6.75. Answer divided by 1350 plus 3021.3 plus 1350. So answer y bar is 200 is verified. Now we know that IXX is equal to IXX 1 plus IXX 2 plus IXX 3. This implies IXX is equal to B1 D1 cube divided by 12 plus A1 into Y bar minus Y1 the whole square. plus b2 d2 cube divided by 12 plus a2 y bar minus y2 the whole square plus b3 d3 cube divided by 12 plus a3 y bar minus y3 the whole square. This implies ixx is equal to b1 d1 cube. b1 is 100 into d1 13.5 the whole cube divided by 12 plus 1350 a1 into y bar is 200 minus y1 is 393.25 the whole square plus b2 is 8.1 multiplied by d2. This is 8.1 and total is 400. Each 13.5 has to be subtracted, therefore we get 400 minus 27. That is nothing but 400 minus 27 is nothing but 373 cube divided by 12 plus 8.1 into 373 multiplied by, that is a2 is 3021.3. y bar is nothing but 200 minus y2 is 200. So 200 minus 200 lead to 0 plus b3 is 100, d3 is 13.5. 100 into 13.5 the whole cube divided by 12 plus 1350 multiplied by y bar is 200, then y3 is 6.75 the whole square. This implies ixx is equal to 100 multiplied by 13.5 the whole cube divided by 12 plus 1350 multiplied by 200 minus 393.25 the whole square plus 8.1 into 373 the whole cube divided by 12 plus 100 multiplied by 13.5 the whole cube divided by 12 answer plus 1350 multiplied by 200 minus 6.75 the whole square is equal to 1359032290.4. IXX is nothing but 1359032290.4. Similarly, IYY is equal to IYY 1 plus IYY 2 plus IYY 3 is equal to D1 B1 cube divided by 12 plus A1 into X bar minus X1 the whole square plus D2 B2 cube divided by 12 A2 X bar minus X2 the whole square plus d3 b3 cube divided by 12 plus a3 x bar minus x3 the whole square. This implies iyy is equal to d1 b1 cube. B1 is 100, d1 is 13.5, therefore 13.5 into 100 cube divided by 12 plus 1350 multiplied by x bar minus x bar is 25.734 minus x1 x bar minus x1, x bar minus x1 is 50 the whole square plus b2 is 8.1, d2 is 373 multiplied by 8.1 the whole cube divided by 12 plus 8.1 multiplied by 373 multiplied by 25.734 minus x2 is equal to 4.05 the whole square plus b3 is 100, d3 is 13.5 d3 b3 cube is 100 plus a3 1350 25.734 minus x3 is nothing but 50 the whole square. This implies IYY is equal to 13.5 multiplied by 100 cube divided by 12 plus 1350 multiplied by 25.734 the whole square minus 50 the whole square plus 373 multiplied by 8.1 the whole cube divided by 12 plus 8.1 multiplied by 373 multiplied by open the bracket 25.734 minus 4.05, we get the answer plus 8.1 multiplied by 373 multiplied by 25.734 minus 4.05 the whole square plus 13.5 multiplied by 100 cube divided by 12 answer plus 1350 multiplied by 25.734 minus 50 the whole square is equal to 5276986.339 mm^4. We summarize x bar is equal to 25.734 mm. Y bar is equal to 200 mm. IXX is equal to 135903229.0 mm^4. IYY is equal to 5276986.339 mm^4.